This morning, I woke up with two things on my mind, ready to go on my to-do list. So I asked Louise to pass me a pen, and between her passing me that pen and it hitting the page, those two things were down to one. Not because I'd already achieved one, but because I had already forgotten one. Apparently I'm getting older, but I just wonder if I've always struggled to remember those kind of things. It's particularly ironic this week though, because there's so much going on about remembering. On the 11th of November, we have Remembrance Day. And so yesterday during our Sunday service, we paused and we stopped to give thanks and to reflect on those who've laid down their lives in military service. Also last week, we were told to remember the 5th of November. And although we couldn't have the usual fireworks and bonfire festivities in our house, we did manage to have a little bit of fun with some sparklers. Add to those that the fact that on Friday evening for the Elim Sound Worship Conference, which was online and is still available for you to check out, Dr. John Andrews brought us a fantastic word about remembering what God has done, how that helps us to move forward and how it helps to fuel our worship today. As King David wrote in Psalm 103, "Praise the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits." And this is why having a routine of remembering is so important and why it's so good to make sure there's a pen right next to your to-do list. And it's why it's important to put things in place that will help us to remember. If you've ever lost a loved one, you will know how important dates like their birthdays or important photos will remind you of them. And if we didn't have Remembrance Day every year, then how much more easily would we forget the freedoms that we enjoy and the gratitude we ought to express to those who laid down their lives. I also very much doubt whether you would have any idea who Guy Fawkes is if you hadn't had a bonfire night every year reminding you of who he was. Important dates in our calendar help us remember certain aspects about who Jesus is and what he means to us too. Christmas is, I don't know, well, it's less than 2 months away. Good Friday, Easter, Pentecost, all these dates in our diary help us to remember certain things about Jesus. But the reality is that those things need to impact our everyday. So what can we do to help us remember? Maybe it would be good for you to keep a journal. Maybe take a photo when God says something to you or speaks to you to remind you of that thing. Perhaps it's time for you to consider routinely taking time to give thanks to God for certain things and making a note of those things. Or maybe there are key Bible verses or truths that God has spoken to you and you could write them down and stick them up as notes around your house. Maybe even when God has said or done something for you, you could take the time to draw or paint or write a poem or write a song about those things to help you remember. Question today is, how can you make sure that you forget not all his benefits? I want to sing the hymn Blessed Assurance, which talks about putting Jesus at the centre of our story every day.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story. My song, praising my Savior.
where did I leave that to-do list?